Awesome. How's everyone doing? I'm Joey Donofrio. I'm the principal owner of Donofrio and Associates Property Inspections, and I am really excited to be here with everyone today. If you have questions, I will do my best to get to them as they come in, but I will make sure I get to them at the end of the presentation as well if I don't see them come in right away. So we'll get started. I know when I start the slide, it may be hard for me to see some of the questions, but we will, like I said, we will get to them. So today we're discussing new construction inspections. I'm very excited to be discussing this with you today. You know, one of the biggest things that I hear is, why do I need an inspection on new construction? Well, you know, like any house, you know, whether it's new, old, there are issues, and we'll dive right in. Why get a home inspection on new construction? Project manager works for the builder. Builder accountability, better to get problems fixed before clients move in. And subcontractors are doing the actual work. One of the biggest things too is, you know, project managers are not just in charge of your house. And now project managers are more salespeople. They are selling you features of the home. And so they have a basic understanding and they're managing the projects. What we think of sometimes when we think of project manager, we think of that old guy that's been doing construction for 30 years, worked his way up. You know, now project managers are often younger and they're more of the front salesperson that's working with your client. You know, people always will say like, hey, well, what do you think of this builder or that builder? And really they're all using the same subcontractors, and it's really how well that project manager is managing the job, spot checking job sites, making sure that windows are caulked, windows are insulated, exterior studs are caulked. And honestly, he doesn't really have the time when a sub comes in to really inspect every single house in the detail that a home inspector would. So it protects you. Protects our clients. You know, houses are oftentimes the biggest purchase we'll ever make, especially new construction. We're paying a premium, and you know, often there's four types of new construction inspections. There's a footers and foundation inspection. This is right when they pour the foundation. A lot of times the slab is not poured, but the footers are poured. So footers and foundation, we're going to be able to see drain tiles if they're down. We're going to be able to see the drains that go below the slab. So there's a lot of cool things that happen in a footers and foundation inspection. And then after that, there's a pre-drywall inspection. And this is after pour the foundation, the wood framing's up. We have a lot of, we're able to see on this pre-drywall, electrical wiring, plumbing going through floors, going through studs, going through joists, and it's really gives us a glimpse of the house before the drywall's up. Sometimes insulation's not in place, and that's okay, but we're going to be able to see the caulking on exterior studs. You know, they say that homes aren't built like they don't build homes like they used to. And I completely agree. They build homes a lot more energy efficient. And a lot of that efficiency comes during that pre-drywall phase. Caulking, insulation around windows, insulation around the exterior doors, fire block between penetrations, between levels of penetration. So we get to see a lot of things that are very important in keeping that home conditioned. I've had an 18-year-old house. My brother had bought a new house. I felt like my air condition always was running, and then I'd go to his house and I never would hear it turn on. One of the most important inspections, say your clients, you maybe can't get a footers, they don't want to do all phases, or maybe the footers and foundation was already poured when they decided to go with the house. The pre-drywall inspection is by far the most important inspection. Because at that point, we're still getting a good look at the foundation. We're seeing the slab poured. We're seeing the interior footers. We're seeing the interior foundation walls. And we get to really take a good look at the house, the bones of the house, before that drywall goes up. The next phase would be final walkthrough inspection. And that's like just doing a normal home inspection on a new construction house. You know, we're going to run and test all your appliances. We're going to, you know, make sure the drains are hooked up. Make sure things are hooked up so when our clients move in, that they're not going to run into any issues, or God forbid they move in and there's a major issue and then they have to move out. We are going to catch a lot of those things during this inspection. The 11-month warranty inspection, typically when the builder, you know, about a year in, the builder will do 11-month warranty inspection, and they'll come by and they'll fix any issues we may find. And so that's a great time to get a home inspection, because whatever we find, the builders typically are going to fix a lot of these issues. And it just gives your client, you know, satisfaction that, oh, wow, a year in, they're going to come back and, you know, some of the issues that we may have lived with or discovered while living there, the builder's going to come in. And when you have a report to give them, it makes it a lot easier for them to get those types of things done. So those are the phases. Footers and foundation inspection. We inspect the main structural components and ensure all beams and bolts are installed properly. We check for general grading around the house and note any waterproofing. We will also inspect rough plumbing, which includes sump pump, draining. The inspection usually takes place right before the slab is poured. So right before the slabs are poured. So typically, we're not seeing houses that are slab foundations. It's always going to be typically footers and foundation, especially in the area that we live in for new construction. Well, you may say, well, Joey, it doesn't have a basement, so it has to be a slab. Nope. It's still going to be a footers and foundation. They just didn't dig out a basement. So it doesn't mean it's slab. You still have foundation walls. Pre-drywall, we start on the outside of the home and inspect foundation to the roof. We inspect all exterior structures that are present, then work inside and look at structural plumbing and electrical systems. This inspection takes place right before insulation and drywall are installed. The builder must also confirm that all the trade inspections have passed in order to schedule this inspection. So typically we like to see that, you know, the code inspectors have come in and already have taken a look at some of this stuff. They don't necessarily have to. That's not necessarily they have to, but we don't want to get to a pre-drywall inspection and it's really not ready for us to do the inspection, meaning electrical's hasn't been installed, plumbing hasn't been installed. You know, those are some of the key things that we want to be able to look at. You know, maybe they haven't caulked exterior studs, and so there's still a lot of to-dos. We almost want it to be ready. We want to come in right before they're about to put up the drywall, maybe the day before, and take a good look at it. We don't need to be there probably 2 weeks before they're about to put drywall, because that means a lot of stuff hasn't been done. And then final walkthrough, it's conducted as the same as a standard home inspection. The builder must confirm that local building and developments have signed off on occupancy permits to schedule this inspection. And then the 11th month warranty inspection, typically crests in the 11th month of the first year after the home is built, right before the builder's home expires. All right. One of the biggest questions that I also get are questions about radon. You know, radon, you know, when do we schedule radon on a new construction inspection? Number one, EPA recommends every house get tested for radon. But what I would say to this one is you may not get it when you do your final walkthrough. Typically, the builder is going to give you a time period to get the radon test done. Typically, it's about a 30-day period. You want to get your radon inspection done on the end of that 30-day period. And this avoids, you know, builders, workers coming and going in and out of the house, and allowing your clients maybe to already live there if they're within that 30 days. But towards the end of that 30 days, typically we can have a more of a controlled environment when we do the radon test, and that allows for less fluctuations in the reading. That's very important. You know, new construction we've seen it all. I've seen things that looked really bad. The good thing is though, on new construction, when we find major issues, the builder is going to fix those issues, you know, and some people will say, well, if they're going to fix them, why even get a home inspection? Well, we don't want our clients to pick a home they love. They wait 6 months for it to be built. They move in and then all of a sudden they discover a major issue to the point where now they have to move out of their house, stay in a hotel for a month. And now we've disrupted their living situation. It becomes a very bad experience. Or even worst case scenario, they live in the house for a year, year and a half, and now they discover a major issue. And now they're outside that 11-month warranty period where the builder says, you know what, maybe we're not going to do anything because we're outside that warranty period. And maybe your inspector, maybe you should have had an inspection done and this would have solved that problem. You know, so we just got to be very careful when it comes to that. But new construction is awesome. It's thriving in our area. I mean, houses are being built like crazy. I have heard that there's been a shortage in some supplies, and it's taking a little bit longer to get appliances and sort of that stuff, which may make the inspection process a little harder. Things might not be in place. Certain appliances that we may not be able to run and test. Okay. Any questions so far? A lot of times, depending on the inspection company, you're going to get bundle packaging when you order all phases of the inspection. So it comes at it'll be a discounted price. So getting all phases can actually then save your clients some money than rather if they didn't get it, they just did one inspection or two inspections. Bundling it up, they can save a lot of money for you guys. All right. So the best way to get a hold, it's important. Remember, it's important to schedule these inspections a day or so prior. A day or so prior to the builder doing their own inspections so that our findings can be given to the builder to add to their reports. So typically, if you're doing a pre-drywall meeting with your builder, you want to do it our inspection the day before. So you have a report or hours before, so then you can give it to the builder and they can go over some of those issues. Or, you know, there's been times where we do it the same day, maybe right before you meet with the builder, you follow us, and then you meet with the builder. But just timing it so that you're doing the final walkthrough with your builder, you want to have our inspection be done right before that. You're doing your pre-drywall inspection with the builder, you want to have a third party inspection right before that. Same with footers and foundation. If they do a walkthrough with that, you want to make sure we're doing it maybe a little bit before that as well. Some builders do not allow third party inspectors to be present at the builder inspections. Actually, most of the time builders don't run us walking through with them. You know, they want us to be, they want you to work with us, and then they want to work with you directly. So a lot of times we're not even there. There's some builders, and this is very important when our clients are picking some of the home to go with, that won't even let them be at our inspection. I don't understand that, but it's just sometimes in their contract that if they get a third party inspection, they're not allowed to be there. I think it has to come down to like liability purposes. But you know, that's one of the hiccups with new construction. But you know, we find a lot of big issues. Sometimes we find some foundational issues, depending on what type of the mixture of the concrete, when the foundation's poured, the type of day it was when it's poured, if it's cooler, warmer out, that has little effect to the drying process of the concrete. And so we run into some of those little issues. Special bundling prices, when you choose Donofrio Associates as your new construction home inspector, we like I said, we offer bundle pricing. And we save clients money to get them into their new house. And that's my presentation. And if you guys have any questions, I'd be more than happy to answer. We are a one-stop shop inspection company. We are starting to market a new service. We do sewer scope inspections, and we don't do any remediation. We're just an inspection company, so we're not looking for issues. We do mold, radon, air quality testing, home inspections, commercial inspections. We want to be that one-stop pool inspections, one-stop shop inspection provider for your clients. So, and we don't, like I said, we don't refer out remediation companies. So there's no incentive for us to find issues with inspection reports. We will be sending out promotional $50 off for our new service. So if you do book a sewer scope, our clients will get $50 off that inspection. So, but thank you guys so much. Really appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you, Joey. This has been really great. I'm Kyle Tranter from NVAR, and I'm just going to help a little bit with the Q&A here. I have a couple questions that have come in that I think you'll be the perfect person to ask to. First, okay. We have Rob Carney asking, is it challenging to time a pre-drywall inspection without causing a delay in the construction?
So that's a great question. So, you know, really, it's, I think a lot of it comes down to open communication with the project manager on when these things can be done. From our standpoint, you know, we only need maybe a day or so lead time, and we can get somebody out there to do the inspection. So just, you know, working with that project manager, making sure that there's an open line of communication and, hey, are we still on pace? Are we still on track? You know, the last thing you want to do, because there's so many different variables with new construction, weather and all that sort of thing. We're coming into a cold spot where if it snows, there might be a delay, or rains a couple days, they might not be able to get out and work on the house. So when they set the pre-drywall target date, know that that's probably a moving target. And so as you start getting up into that, hey, we're 2 weeks out. Hey, are we still on pace? Hey, are we still on pace? A week out? Hey, 3-4 days out, are we still on pace? And really just communicating well with that project manager that nothing's going to be delayed. But that was a great question, because yeah, you got to, on a new construction, you have to follow up and stay on top, and don't rely on them to communicate with you. You got to almost be upfront with them and say, hey, are we still all ready to roll?
Mm-hmm. Great. Next we have Joel Murray, who asks, do builders ever hire companies like yours to inspect homes that they are building for quality control purposes?
Yes. So they do hire inspection companies for quality control. There's actually some builders that they'll do a quality control inspection before. You know, sometimes these quality control inspections are a little different than what a home inspection is, where they may be looking at more cosmetic issues and, you know, sort of that thing, where when a home inspection is more functionality testing. So it's a little different, but I think that's great. I think one of the companies is Van Meter. They do quality control inspections. But, you know, that's, know that they're working for the builder. They're not working for the client.
And next up we have Grace Mukai, says, approximately how much does a new construction inspection cost?
Around, I would say the average is around $400. You know, depending on, different inspection companies will base it off of age, square footage. But you know what, make sure, because different inspection companies offer different things with their home inspections, where some inspection companies may offer warranties, like 90 day or roof protection, where another inspection company might not have any of that. So, you know, not every inspection company is created equal and provides the same services. So make sure that they're, you know, they're comparable when you're comparing prices, that they're comparable companies that you're comparing.
And we have another question from Rob Carney. Do you do lead-based paint inspections? And he also says specifically for older homes.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, so we do lead-based paint inspections. The only time you get a lead-based paint inspection, their home is built prior to 1978. So you don't need to get a lead-based paint inspection on a new home. Only older homes would have lead, 1978. And the older you get from 1978, the more chances that house may have lead. Just because it's 1978 or before doesn't mean that there's lead. You know, I think it's about 25% of homes built in 1978 or before, between 1960 and 1978, have lead. And then between 1950, 1960, it just keeps increasing in the chances that you may have lead in those homes.
Great. And then the last question I see here is from Mariana Bridges. It says, how often would you say you find radon issues in new construction?
So, I can't, to be honest with you, I don't know the exact stat on that. I can give you a general stat of, you know, based on the inspections that we perform, about 30% of the homes out of the 4,000 a year that we do have radon levels above 4.0 picocuries per liter. You know, radon is very tricky because, you know, the EPA recommends every house get tested for radon every 2 years. It doesn't even matter if it's been remediated or not. So, you know, the best thing that we can do is say, hey, EPA recommends every house get tested for radon, and leave it up to our clients. I've heard things when it comes to radon, you know, out of the years that we've been in business, especially before, you know, about 5-10 years ago, you'd hear, oh, you don't need radon because there's a walkout, or you don't need radon because there's no basement. And All somebody has to do is ask Alexa, ask Siri, go to Google, fact check you, and they will come to the conclusion that you're lying to them, because the EPA recommends every house get tested for radon. Now you can say, hey, the percent chance is a little bit lower, but you could still have radon on a slab. You could still have radon if you live in a crawl space. You could still have radon on a second level condo. You could still have radon in a condo. So we just have to be careful with how we communicate that with our clients, you know, and when we're telling them about radon. But the last thing you want to do is say, you don't need a radon test. And they move into their house, they talk to their neighbor's house got tested high, and then that could come back to you. And people tend to share bad news over good news. So we just have to be careful with how we present that by giving them the, you know, giving them the information and letting them make the informed decision on whether they want to move forward with it or not. But I'm glad we brought that up. Any other questions we may have? Well, guys, I really appreciate the time today. I really appreciate you being here. I know the next class, I believe, is tomorrow at 10 a.m. So look forward to, hopefully that's a great class you guys did attend and you're getting a lot of information today. And, you know, one of the biggest things I can tell you for our company is use us as a resource. You know, even if we're not part of the transaction, maybe you're the listing agent, maybe you're dealing with a mold issue, maybe a contractor's come in and said something and you want our opinion on how big of a deal something is, or, you know, what our take is on it. We would love to help you out. We would love to be a resource for you. You know, we're never going to come in and combat somebody's report just because I think that's extremely unprofessional, but I'd be more than happy to give you my opinion on some things. Maybe you're a listing agent, you're trying to determine how big, how serious some of these issues and maybe another inspector's report are, and you want a sounding board to kind of bounce something off of. We'd be more than happy to help you. You know, you don't have to do it alone. Use your resources, and we can help decipher a lot of stuff for you and be there to you. You know, mold is so tricky. Sometimes I read mold reports and I'm like, what the heck's going on? It's like, I feel like I'm back in college. It's not clear. It's hard to understand. So anything like that, we'd be more than happy to help you and be a resource for you guys. So really appreciate the time today and hope everyone has a great week.